We'll be right back. Alrighty. Everything appears to be in order, and I shall start a little bit earlier than usual. So I am live. Okay, welcome back to the live stream. My name is Ed. And if you're joining me for the first time, I am currently drawing the major players of the pop idols of the 1990s. So where I left off last time was with the Spice Girls, and I figured, why not continue? We've got some more to draw, so let's kick this off. Okay. You'll have to excuse me if I frequently get interrupted by my phone buzzing, but it's just the nature of how these things tend to be. I wasn't exactly happy with the likeness I got for some of these. So I'll be focusing on Jerry Halliwell here, who I kind of botched the likeness of, because I was drawing her a little bit too quickly. Then it helps if I've got the right layer selected. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna go back and rework an old drawing. Like, there's not a huge amount of work I've got to do here, but I do want to make it a little bit more accurate. And I want to work obviously a little bit slower, because I kind of rushed it last time. because when you're drawing caricatures, the main thing you want is for them to be instantly recognizable. I'm just going to do a quick sound check. So I think Jerry was always my favorite. Like, she's the one Spice Girl who arguably had the best career post Spice Girls. Although, pretty much all of them, I think, have done all right. So if I had to, I guess, make a, this sort of what's the word I'm looking for? Out of the Spice Girls, which one did the best? Sort of from first to last, I'd say I think Scary Spice has stayed well and truly in the public eye as like a judge on like talent shows. Like all these girls had like pretty solid pretty solid careers sort of after their fame kind of, I guess, dried up on them. So I think I made her body a little bit too stern looking. It's like these guys really didn't get along. Lots of infighting. That kind of thing happens, unfortunately, when it comes to girl bands. It's amazing how, like, something you did so long ago, like when you were in your 20s, can have such a profound effect on the rest of the world. Modify this pose just slightly. They are very much about like the whole peace sign. Like Richard Nixon kind of peace sign thing back then. See, I was in high school when the Spice Girls really hit it big. weird thing as well is like, Britney Spears was big back then as well. And I had no real idea back then, like, just what actually was going down. I don't think really anybody did. We sort of have this sort of strange, like, vision of celebrities being, you know, a bit more in control. Like, everyone just sort of automatically looks up to celebrities. Oh, that reminds me, Taylor Swift is in this country. That's a whole thing. She's so massively popular that they've put on extra bus services just to get to Sydney's Olympic Park where she's doing her show. And she's got her rehearsals on and stuff. Always been fascinated by that kind of how that all comes together. But the thing is, I've been working in entertainment for a while now. And you do, you just get sort of when you work in entertainment like I do, because I do a lot of like live parties and stuff, like you end up talking to the other entertainers. And, you know, I've worked at parties where there's just been, like, musicians, DJs, professional singers, magicians, acrobats, you know, all kinds. And I've even worked with a mime. He wasn't really the best in conversation. Surprisingly good at what he does, but yeah, not a big talker. See, I can just kind of, you know, prattle on for hours, just doing my thing. Now, obviously, this particular episode of Sketch Jam, I'm not taking requests. But if you're lurking in the chat and you want to say hi, don't be shy. What crazy about this hand? Listening to a lot of the original soundtrack to the Soul Reaver's Legacy of Kain series, and I gotta tell you, that music still holds up to this day. It's like spooky and atmospheric, and yet for some reason very, very like would not be out of place at a disco. These guys, when they were together, they were cranking out the hits like nothing else. It's interesting now that I've started sort of going back and watching concerts and stuff. GoPro is out. I haven't been much for action cams. Really, the only cameras I need are the ones that are currently in front of me. I kind of captured Posh Spice. I don't think I did her justice. She was always my favorite because she was like the strong silent type. Which loosely translates to hot and didn't say very much. See, unlike the Pussycat Dolls, the Spice Girls did have way more like individual personalities. Like, girl groups after these guys started kind of not having nearly the same level of like cultural impact. Possums in the roof. Of course we do. This is kind of another one that I rushed through. She's a pretty angular looking girl. Mrs. Beckham. Take my time more with this one, I think. Like, the shading is, I guess, a little excessive, but you know. I think the fact that the 90s was ...30 years ago is enough to give us pause. Like, 1994. So I would have been 10 years old. Exaggerated. More of these exaggerated, slender Gumby proportions. I remember Posh Spice in the Spice World movie. Okay. Figured now would be a good time. Just to chill for a bit. It's a little bit distracting. But I've never had this kind of cereal before. So, wrong pen. A few, I guess, important announcements. The countdown has begun. Well, it's still going. But as of episode 70, a whole suite of new exciting and permanent changes will be coming to the live stream. I won't be doing eating live streams like this. This is more to kill time. I was at the gym last night. And you know that feeling you sometimes get when you push yourself a little too hard and your body's just like, no, this isn't a case of mind over matter, my dude. I need to lie down. Because one way or another, as much as we try to kid ourselves, that we have some kind of, you know, preemptive control. Over health. well-being or longevity. Time catches up to us. She ends up as the wife of football legend and local character David Beckham.
All you can eat, Puffy, here is the...
Next up is Sporty Spice. It's actually really cool. This is the first live stream I've done in a while. It doesn't have things like dropped frames. Yeah. That was a bit of all right. So Sporty Spice was always kind of the, she wasn't the best looking of them, but she had like the most personality. Well, they all kind of had like certain amounts of personality, but I think Sporty Spice dominated. So This pose is fine, but it's boring. So I'm gonna appear to have completely killed my music. Hang on. She had sort of these jagged teeth. Very traditionally English teeth. She was always about the always about the crop tops and the sneakers. Something a little bit more dynamic here. Find out the rest of the ones that are got to be drawing. Okay, so I've got a few more. To draw after these guys. Turn down that music just a teeny bit. It's kind of at obnoxious levels at the moment. But at least it's playing. Vast improvement from it being off. I think she had her teeth like fixed or whatever. She used to have like a gold tooth. Really looked after herself, that one. Looks great for her age. She'd be at the very least in her mid-50s. Yeah, let me check. How old are the Spice Girls? Okay, so Melanie B is Melanie Brown, and Melanie C is Melanie Chisholm. Which is, if you say it really quickly, yeah, then they're in their 50s. They'd be in their 50s. Yeah, so you got Ginger Spice born, Ginger Spice born 1972, Baby Spice 1976. They burst onto the scene in 1994. Yeah, they're all Gen X's. They were largely responsible for entertaining the, what are they called? Millennials, which is my generation. Like, I've said this before in previous live streams, but I'm not like a millennial who like, I'm an older millennial. I'm what's known as an ex-lineal. I was born very close to the tail end of the 70s, 83 to be precise. Okay, I'm liking this one a lot more. Let's see what these guys look like now. Shrinking down a little bit. A little bit more consistent. Let's move on to Melanie Brown. AKA Scary Spice. So actually I'll throw in a bit more skin tone because she's black. I need to rush these. So the 90s was basically the decade that I was a kid in. And it's interesting seeing how differently people who were born the same year as so many celebrities have aged by comparison. For some reason, celebrities, by and large, just don't age as poorly as the rest of us. Like, obviously, some of them, you know, get a little bit crazy for themselves. I don't know why they called her Scary Spice. I mean, she was kind of scary, but not like, you know, you'd be actually afraid of her. I guess she picked that name because it's a bit like the movie Reservoir Dogs. Nobody was able to be Mr. Black. Everyone had to be kind of a secondary color. So I guess another announcement regarding the live stream is there's a good to very high chance that I won't be going live very much at all in April. Because I'll be doing some traveling. And where I'm going, the internet is not particularly good. It's actually one of the most annoying part of the whole thing. It's I can use the internet for so much stuff, you know, that you take for granted and everything. Oh, that's a good one, a scary spice. I'm just going to... reuse these layers at a later point. Again, these are just, you know, these are roughs. The finished art won't be quite so crude and sketchy looking. However, that sketchy look that was pretty prevalent in Disney cartoons from like the 1970s. Like basically after Walt passed away, the Disney company was kind of in disarray. And some might argue that it never fully recovered. All right. Yeah, Baby Spice, she completely vanished. I'm pretty sure she's, you know, she does the occasional public appearance, but she hasn't been active at all since the Spice Girls broke up. Slam your body down and wind it all around. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give these guys more of a proper screen presence. Okay, something appears to have happened. Oh, well, isn't this a predicament? Well, I guess this is better time than any to sign off for the night. It's getting late, and yeah, the fact that my iPad just stopped working for some reason is a good indicator for me to call it in and say check out the upcoming news regarding the special changes that I'll be implementing by episode 70. I can't believe I've I've hit that milestone so quickly. So, yeah, until next time, I'll